Welcome back, fellow scientists. Justin here. Mia and I are headed to the amusement park today. Oh, I can't wait. There's gonna be cotton candy, roller coasters, bumper cars. Ooh, Mia, check out that ride. Those are some giant swings. Everyone's flying around and around. It looks like so much fun. Oh, I think you're onto something, Mia. That does look a lot like planets when they revolve around the sun. But those swings keep spinning around instead of flying off because they're held to the ride by strong metal chains. Planets don't have chains, so what keeps planets moving around and around the sun? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to describe four main parts of our solar system and figure out the invisible force that keeps everything in motion. Let's investigate. Before we figure out what keeps everything moving in our solar system, we need to know what's actually out there. What is the solar system anyway? Well, the word solar means sun, so yeah, the sun is definitely a key player. The solar system is the sun and all of the objects that revolve or move around it. But what are those objects exactly? In addition to the sun, our solar system includes planets, their moons, tons of space rocks, and even icy objects way out near the edge. Some parts of the solar system are really close to the sun. Others are really far away, but they're all part of the same system, each one moving along its own path around the same star. Let's take a quick tour of the solar system and check out its most important parts. Since the solar system is named after the sun, it sounds pretty important to me. The sun is a giant ball of hot gas at the center of our solar system. It gives off the heat we feel here on Earth and the light we see during the day. And it's the main source of energy for the entire solar system. Around the sun, we've got the planets. Planets are large, round objects that orbit the sun. In our solar system, there are 8 of them. The 4 planets closest to the sun are called the inner planets. They are smaller and mostly made of rock. The 4 outer planets are much bigger and are mostly made of gas. Don't worry, we'll explore all the planets in more detail in future lessons. Okay, so the solar system includes the sun and everything that orbits around it, like the planets. But what else do you think might be part of it? I'll give you a hint. You've probably spotted one in the night sky. A moon! A moon is a natural object that revolves around a planet. And Earth isn't the only planet with one. In fact, most planets in our solar system have moons orbiting around them. Earth only has one moon, but some planets have a whole bunch. This picture shows a few of the moons in our solar system compared to Earth. Our moon is the one on the left. As you can see, some moons are much larger than ours. But others are much smaller. Moons come in many different shapes and sizes. Just like the planets, they move through space in regular paths called orbits. So, we've seen 3 of the main parts of our solar system. The sun, the planets, and the moons. There's one part left. Do you spot anything in the picture we haven't talked about yet? Between the inner and outer planets is something very interesting. The asteroid belt. The asteroid belt is a wide zone filled with chunks of rock called asteroids. Unlike the round planets, asteroids are usually small and lumpy. Some people say they look like space potatoes, but I doubt they would taste very good. The solar system is made of so many huge moving parts, planets, their moons, and asteroids all moving around the sun. But what keeps everything moving along its path? Remember that swing ride we saw earlier? The chains keep each swing connected to the center. That way, when the ride spins, the swings move around the ride instead of zooming away. But in space, there aren't any chains, so why don't the planets just fly off? The answer is a powerful, invisible force called gravity. You might remember gravity from when we talked about tides. It's the same force that pulls ocean water to create high and low tides on Earth. Gravity is a force that pulls objects toward each other. It's what keeps you on the ground, makes things fall when you drop them, and keeps the planets orbiting the sun. The strength of gravity depends on two things. The first is mass. Mass tells us how much material is packed into an object. It's like how full your suitcase is when you pack. More stuff inside means more mass. The more mass something has, the stronger its gravity. The sun is very large and has a ton of mass. That's why it has such strong gravity and why it can keep all the planets orbiting around it. But wait, the sun has way more mass than any planet, so why do moons orbit planets at all? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Well, it isn't just about mass. The strength of gravity depends on two things, mass and distance. The closer two objects are to each other, the stronger the gravity between them. Even though planets have less mass than the sun, they're much closer to their moons. At that distance, a planet's gravity has a stronger pull on its moon, keeping the moon in orbit around it. Gravity is what holds the solar system together. It's what keeps all of the objects in their solar system in their orbit. Let's review everything we've learned today. We explored the solar system and some of its major parts: the sun, the planets, the asteroid belt, and the moons. We also discovered that everything stays in motion thanks to a force called gravity. To learn more about our solar system, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. That's right, Mia. Gravity is the invisible chain that holds the solar system together, just like the chains on the swings. Speaking of which, I think Mia and I are ready to go on that ride. Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time. Hey.